I don't know whether it's because people's fascination with death, life and death, and, you know, every, like, a human urge, the main human urge in life is to survive. But if you have, like, an apocalypse, you impede in that survival. So I think that the fascination comes around this thing that we don't understand, which is death. We don't know what happens after death. And I think that in modern day society, especially in the Western world, we don't live in war-torn countries, you know. We actually live like a Western civilized life. So the concept of the other is, one, terrifying. It's like, two, something that we don't actually know. So I think that just something that we have a high interest to understand and we're not experiencing in this moment.
Why do you think as a species we are so fascinated with the concept of our own demise?
I mean, it's the ultimate concept, isn't it? It's the ultimate kind of idea that everything could just disappear, you know. And I love that about the show, that it sort of forces you to look out further out, you know. It forces you to kind of perceive the world we live in from space, you know. And to sort of see us floating on this rock in the middle of, you know, the solar system, gives you a very interesting perspective, you know. And yeah, the fact that it could all disappear, and if that did come about, how would we deal with that? How would society deal with that? And I think that's what's great about it as a TV show, is because you can actually spend time with the characters, with the concept, and really look into how are people going to deal with knowing that the world is going to end. Is it going to just totally turn into chaos and an unlawful, you know, society? Are people going to turn to religion? Are people going to turn their back on religion and go against religion? You know, so there's all these really interesting ideas that the kind of show kind of brings up. All the while, you know, it's really a story about family, and it's about, you know, how you try and protect your loved ones and look after the people that you love, you know. I think ultimately, you know, I mean, we talked about it a lot, you know, and there are people that are going to want to cause chaos. There's going to be people that want to find peace, you know, and make sure that the last sort of days on earth are full of love and, you know, tranquility. And then there's going to be people who want to just tear the place apart, you know. And I think I can relate to sort of Hicks's situation, in which you would just want to protect and make sure that the people that you love, you were close to the people that you love, you know, and that you try and help them through something like that as much as possible, you know. So yeah, there were sort of relatable themes in that sense.
You have to ask yourself, what would you do if time was running out? What would you do if you know you only had 5 years left? Would you still stick to all the norms, all the laws, or would you just go, oh, forget it, we're all going to go, so I might as well enjoy myself and misbehave? But I don't know if I can make it last for 5 years of misbehaving. But I think that's why, because I think the rules have all changed, and people would not probably act. I think that's what this show does. It shows you people acting in ways that they wouldn't normally do.
Why are we so fascinated with the concept of our own demise? Well, it's not a crazy idea, considering that the President of the United States of America is tweeting about setting off a nuclear war. It's not the most impossible thing in the world right now. So we either are fascinated with it and watch programs like Hard Sun, or want to run away and watch The Bake Off. So it's one or the other. So that's I suppose I seesaw between watching Hard Sun and The Bake Off. That would be my ideal evening. Hard Sun, panic! Ah, a cake. I mean, the interesting thing is, and I suppose maybe humans haven't gotten their head around this, the world could end in 5 years for any of us. We don't get to live forever. I'm sorry if that's a showbiz exclusive, that you don't live forever. I feel like we're all already spending so much time on social media that in a panic we would just watch The Bake Off and scroll through our Instagram, and then the 5 years would be up and we're like, what, already? So I feel like we would all love to think we'd go travelling and discover a new species of frog, but in reality, we'd probably all waste our time just eating a load of biscuits. I'd say we'd all get really overweight and be like, ugh, how nice to just chill out and know that you never have to, like, do any exercise again. You can just eat biscuits and burgers. Like, just throw it all in the bin. Like, that's what I do. I just sit around eating burgers all day. Yeah. And I'd say that would be a life well lived.
I think everyone loves doom and gloom. Nobody knows what's going to happen. No one knows what's going to happen at the end of the world. And because this is, well, it's pre-apocalyptic, I think everyone's being saying. So it's quite interesting watching how everyone prepares and changes towards the end of the world, which I think is what everyone really imagines. No one imagines what happens afterwards. I think they imagine what just happens just before and what the hell would you do when it's all going horribly wrong.
How do you think you would handle living in the world of Hard Sun yourself?
I wouldn't handle it well. I mean, I'd probably get a bit wild. I don't know, I'd do some stupid things. You know, you want to be with the people who you're close with. Maybe go and do all the stuff you've never been brave enough to do before. Go and buy an enormous hat and wear it down the street. Bring platform boots back into fashion. You know, things like that, I think I'd probably do. Daniel, however, reacts a bit differently. Not so many platform boots, a lot more knives.
The fascination for apocalypse is abiding. It transcends all narrative, all cultures, all time. There's always been an end times narrative, but I don't think it's nihilistic, because when we imagine those stories, when we tell those stories to ourselves, when we watch those stories being told, we're identifying with the survivors, not with the dead. And I think actually what those stories are about is not about destruction, but about transformation. And we're imagining... we're imagining how our lives would be if they were stripped back to the bare essentials. If all of the quotidian, everyday problems that we all deal with every day were stripped away, and it all was left was the people we cared about and how we'd survive. I think these stories are a way of us exploring our fantasies and our aspirations to be our best selves. Apocalypse narratives are actually stories about us being at our absolute best.